But if the heterodox papists are likewise members of the church, then orthodoxy is, in some sense, a defective church, and is unable, according to the ecumenist of the Fanar, to witness by herself to evangelical truth.
Για να επικρατήσει σήμερα η χριστιανική αλήθεια σε όλο τον κόσμο, πρέπει να είναι αξιόπιστος. Και για να είναι αξιόπιστος πρέπει να προέρχεται από μια ενωμένη χριστιανική εκκλησία και όχι κατατεμαχισμένη.
The unity of the body of Christ.
And prayer is required if unity is to be accomplished, and orthodoxy is thereby to be given full potential for witnessing.
Awaken the minds of Christians so that in a penitential spirit we may seek to bring to perfection the unity of the body of Christ.
The course of this dialogue, unfortunately, justified the deepest anxieties of the Orthodox anti-ecumenists. Common worship and joint prayer between Orthodox ecumenists and papists were and continue to be on the daily agenda.
Wisdom, arise. Let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Father, grant that we may, with one heart and voice, glorify your holy name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever through the ages to come.
However, patristic tradition and the decisions of the synods permit this only insofar as there is a communality and oneness of faith. But how can this be the case, since papism is cut off from the Orthodox Church? Since it innovated in the errors of dogma and tradition? Since it has always been regarded as a most ancient heresy? How can we forget the Orthodox view that Catholicism and Protestantism together constitute the complete distortion of Christianity, which the Orthodox Church alone preserves intact? The Orthodox anti-ecumenists call to mind that the 7th plenary session of the Joint International Commission for Theological Dialogue, which met in June of 1993 in Balamand, Lebanon, preached a truly new ecclesiology. Catholics and Orthodox are once again discovering each other as sister churches and recognizing each other as sister churches.
Πρέπει όλοι να συστρατευθούμε με φόβο Θεού, ξεπερνούντες τις αυτάρκες προσκολήσεις μας στις τυπικές εκφράσεις της Εκκλησίας μας, οι οποίες πολλές φορές μας δυσκολεύουν να αναγνωρίσουμε έξω από τα δικά μας όρια, αδελφούς και αδελφές, να αναγνωρίσουμε εκκλησίες στην πλήρη έννοια της λέξης Εκκλησίας.
Εκπρόσωποι του Αγιωτάτου Πάπα Ρώμης Ιωάννου Παύλου του Δευτέρου και της καταρτών Εκκλησίας, υπό την ηγεσία της Φιλτάτης ημίν και της περί ημάς αδελφής ημετέρας Σεβασμιότητος, καρδινάλιε κύριε Κάσιτη, χαίρομαι ιδιαίτερος ότι εν τον προσώπου ημών αδελφή χαιρετίζομαι να άπαξ έτη εν αγάπη και τιμή τον εν τη δύση αγιότατον πρεσβύτερον αδελφών ημών, Πάπα Ιωάννη Παύλου.
By virtue of this new ecclesiology, the ecumenists now address the papal flock as if they were Orthodox.
Fili diletti della Chiesa, festeggiamo quindi insieme al venerando vescovo di questa città, il nostro caro fratello Papa Giovanni Paolo II, ed insieme all'intera Chiesa di Roma, questa sacra festa e grande solennità. Festeggiamo quindi insieme, Oriente ed Occidente, il dono è concesso da Dio. Festeggiamo, poiché siamo la comunione militante dei santi, del Dio della vita, del Dio della gioia.
They proclaim that Orthodox and Catholics supposedly have a common baptism.
Con il santo battesimo
ελάβατε δια του Αγίου Βαπτίσματος και του Χρίσματος τα χαρίσματα του Αγίου Πνεύματος. Φέρετε εν τη ψυχή και εν το μετόπο ημών τα σημεία της Βασιλείας του Θεού.
Father, through your only begotten Son Jesus Christ our Lord, you have brought us to the recognition of your truth, so that linked by your own faith and baptism, we may become his body.
Talk about a broad or wider church, which also includes non-Orthodox.
Έχουμε την ίδια πίστη των Αποστόλων, με μια ποικιλία θεολογικών εκφράσεων κάποτε ή και λειτουργικών παραδόσεων θεμητών, οι οποίες όχι μόνο δεν προσκρούν στην ουσία της κοινής παραδεδομένης πίστεως, αλλά αντιθέτως εμπλωτίζουν την κοινωνία της πίστεως και της αγάπης.
And both sides take part in each other's patronal feasts, praying together and giving joint blessings, as if they had the same faith. The Orthodox anti-ecumenists who follow the old calendar discern with great distress that in spite of the protests of the faithful over the very grave deviations of the ecumenists, the latter have a clear conscience and state that they will continue their efforts.
Από τις βολές αυτές και τις επικρίσεις δεν επηρεάζομαι, διότι έχω ήσυχη την συνείδησή μου και πιστεύω ότι αυτό το οποίο επιτελώ και ως πρόσωπο και ως εκκλησία Κωνσταντινούπολης είναι το θέλημα του Θεού.
On this occasion, I publicly express the most cordial invitation and the strongest hope that before too long this joint commission for theological dialogue, which up to now has met in Europe and in the Middle East, may meet for the first time in the Western Hemisphere, in the United States, and specifically here in Maryland, where its members would receive a warm and gracious welcome.
Thus, this year, in June of 1999, despite the reaction of the majority of the local Orthodox churches, although the Vatican is sticking to its guns, although the problem of the Unia has not become any less acute. After an interruption lasting 6 full years, the Joint International Commission will convene once again, this time in Baltimore, USA, to continue the dialogue.
Χριστού Κυρίου ημών Ιησού Χριστού και η αγάπη του Θεού και Πατρός και η κοινωνία του Αγίου Πνεύματος ή με τα πάντων ημών.
The Orthodox anti-ecumenists are certain that this time the ecumenists of the Fanar not only will not urge the papists to repent, but will ratify and enact the natural and necessary ramifications and corollaries of the anti-Orthodox Balaman agreement. how far away will this be from the false union of Ferrara, Florence? And how is it possible for the old calendarist Orthodox anti-ecumenists to cease addressing this anguished question stemming from brotherly love to the ecumenists? Quo vadite, Orthodoxi ecumenisti? Whither go ye, O Orthodox ecumenists? The recent visits of the Pope in 1999 to Orthodox countries, for the first time since the Schism of 1054, proved yet again that ecumenism, as an ecclesiological disease of epidemic proportions, is relentlessly hitting many regions of the Orthodox world. Ecumenist politesse leads the Orthodox into unceasing compromises, sacrifices and concessions. The gradual loss of any sense of the nature and destructive power of heresy, not to mention the blatant and unacceptable hobnobbing with the heterodox at places and times of worship, were more evident in Romania than at any other time. How, one wonders, could the Orthodox have allowed the leader of the Vatican State, wearing vestments, to attend the synodal liturgy at which Patriarch Theotist of Romania presided? How could an Orthodox patriarch have been so oblivious to the heretical character of the Pope as to have allowed him to join with him in blessing the Orthodox flock? And all of this, notwithstanding the fact that Uniate aggression, even in Western Romania, in Transylvania, under the full protection of the Vatican, has driven the Orthodox Catholic dialogue into a complete impasse.
Και κρατέωσον βασιλείς ους ηγάτησας.
Αμήν.
Ρικόρδατι in primo luogo, Signore, del nostro Santissimo Padre, Giovanni Paolo, Papa di Roma, dell'Arcivescovo Carlo Maria, e concedi alle Tue sante Chiese che essi vivano in pace, incolumi, onorati, sani, longevi, e dispensino rettamente la tua parola di verità.
Why do we observe this compliant attitude towards the Vatican State and John Paul II, its Pope Caesar, when it is a known fact that Vatican diplomacy continually torpedoes the sincerity and credibility of this dialogue? Could it really be that the tragedy of the 15th century is being repeated? How is it possible for the Orthodox ecumenists to hope for any aid whatsoever from the Pope when he has lost the treasure of the truth and his sights are always set on proselytizing? The pious old calendarist Orthodox anti-ecumenists lament the fall of their ecumenist brothers who are constantly yielding to the papal imperium. They lament the capture of Orthodox Romania and Orthodox Georgia. Is the truth not sacrificed when honors are accorded to the leader of the Vatican State by the entire Orthodox hierarchy of Georgia, and indeed lined up along with the representatives of other religions?